Everybody, it's Victor on the Continued Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victor After Earth Plus series. Happy Monday, everyone out there. Hope you had a good start to your new week here in the Mosh Pit. Here's your meme of the day. First off, like streak counter back on target. Thank you all very much for making that happen. Secondly, here's your meme of the day brought to you by PenPen. And this one actually got a legitimate lol from me because it is just so good. It's also like a newer meme on the subreddit, so it didn't have a whole lot of upvotes, but definitely worth your time checking out. Drop. Soul heart. Drop a soul heart. Drop a golden chest. Well, thank you very much to PenPen and those of you who did upvote it. Again, it didn't have a whole lot. It's not a new meme. I mean, it's new as in like on the subreddit. You know what I mean, you freaking jokers out there. It's going to be Lima Hotel, 1-2, Papa Foxtrot, Foxtrot Golf. We've got 53 range, thanks to Tapeworm, Portable Slot, Gimpy, and a really dorky haircut. I can already tell. Good tiers, bad damage, bad movement speed, like really bad movement speed. Anytime you're sub-9, like sub-0.9 movement speed, you know you're not in for a fun time. But our DPS should remain halfway respectable here, even though it's only 2.88 base damage because of the fact that we have a 7-tier delay, so that's going to be very, very nice. And of course, Gimpy gives us a little bit of extra leeway here, so if we do take early damage, we may have a chance of getting a soul heart back out of that. Gimpy goes very well, again, with, like, say, blood donation machines, IV bad, basically anything. I'm going to take Walnut because we just flat out don't need 53 range, and if we do happen to take damage, at least not only can we get a Gimpy payout, but we also might get a Walnut payout. Should be very cool indeed. I thought I was heading towards the item room. Turns out I was bamboozled. You have to forgive me. I actually have a kind of a bad headache right now. I did a grocery run because we needed some supplies for the house, and we are now required to wear. I don't think it's required, and I may have misspoke on this week's GeoGuessr episode because like I don't watch the local news. I don't watch regular news. But I was told by multiple members of my family that that you have to wear face masks now when you go outside. And I've never worn a face mask, let alone like a one of the fancy N95 face masks or whatever. I mean, it's not something that I've ever had to do. So I went to the grocery store, and about halfway through, I was only there for maybe 20 minutes tops, and about maybe like 10 minutes after being there, I started getting a massive headache, and I mean. I'm not a person who gets that bad of headaches. Like, I get headaches every now and then, but that's usually due to, like, sinus pressure and stuff. But this was out of nowhere, and, like, my head was just killing me. So I don't know if the mask was too tight or if I was, like, breathing weird or anything. I mean, like, I did feel awkward because, like, I'm not used to it. So I took to Twitter just to ask that, and most people seem to say that it's probably just because I'm just not used to wearing one, which is true. I've literally never had to wear a mask. The only time I've had to wear any sort of mask was when I was I was hospitalized for pneumonia, severe pneumonia, many years ago, and one of my lungs collapsed, and that's when I had to be put on a ventilator, and I had to wear like this special mask or something. I mean, I was in and out of it; like it was not fun. But obviously, I mean, obviously, I recovered, unless I didn't, and this is all a simulation. Well, then, if this is a simulation, I wish I would have picked myself like a better time to simulate the world, because, man, it's everyone stay safe out there. We're going to go with the blue hourglass here. The glowing hourglass is going to at least help us in case we do take bad damage. I can rewind the room and try again. That's about it. I mean, there's not really a whole lot you can do with a glowing hourglass. It can be good in situations. Like, if you do take some bad damage, it gives you, like, kind of like a forgiveness do-over. But for the most part, it definitely is not going to take priority over a majority of our spacebar items available. And we'll just head on down, though. Not a bad start. I'm just super not used to having, like, just massive headaches. Like, it was real bad. I'm glad that I can laugh now because, like, I feel better. Like, it's taken me about maybe 30 minutes since I've been back from the grocery store. And, I'm feeling better now. Like, my headache is not nearly as bad as it was. But it's still kind of lingering right now, so. Wow, that spider pushed the other spider that was pausing directly into us. That's a good trick, game. Very good. And so we lost the soul heart that we got from Latchkey. No. We definitely... I wouldn't mind a better spacebar item. The Victor can use some glowing hourglass that. Well, it's because we still have two soul hearts, and losing one soul heart in a total of three is not a big deal, especially on floor two, because that's like we're still not going to be able to take a devil deal no matter what. A second one, I mean. So undoing that one soul heart is not that big of a deal. Plus, we have so many tinted rocks here. I hope that we just get a bomb and just, you know, have it be done. The trap in this room is to go up through that gap there. Don't ever do that, because that's what the game wants you to do. You'll get swarmed from the right, and then you've essentially trapped yourself in an alleyway that you cannot escape from. So do not come up here at first glance. I know that seems like the proper way to do it, but you have to remember there's a second swarm of these flies that spawn in the upper right of this room, and they will make a beeline, or I should say a fly line, straight for you. So don't do that. So do what I do. You want to give them the triple deke. You go here, then you go whoop, up and around that way. That's the easiest way to do it. We get Dad's key, which is marginally better, I guess. It's maybe not marginally. That's a little unfair. It's slightly better. Not quite marginal, but it's also better than marginal. Because at least this saves us keys. Like we can get inside of that a double locked door room, which is most likely a vault. It could be a dice room though, which I wouldn't mind. Would I reroll this run? Let's wait till we see what we get out of our devil deal first. Not get ahead of ourselves. We got a whole lot of run to go. This is only floor two, all right? Just take a chill pill. Of course, another nice thing about Dad's key is that you can open up secret rooms and super secret rooms without having to use a bomb for it, which is very nice. And yes, it can also open up the golden mega stand door. Now, are we going to do that on this run? Well, if you ask me that in a couple minutes when we're actually there, you know. Yeah, so I opened up both secret rooms and super secret rooms without having to use a bomb, which is very nice. I would still like to get a bomb, though, because I want to go and get those tinted rocks. Yeah, so I'll go back and get that full charge that we got in the other room to open up the curse room. Okay. There we go. Was it all worth it? Well, let's see. No. And no. All right. I'm still going to go into the double lock door, probably after we're done clearing this heck hole of a room. Are you kidding me? That Blastocyst didn't die, huh? Wow, that Blastocyst was still alive. Okay, our damage is actually a lot worse than I realized. Yeah, 2.88 is pretty trash-mastic. Trash-tastic. And now I immediately regret getting rid of the glowing hourglass because I could have gotten that back. So, yeah. Losing an entire soul heart in this room is not surprising with this damage, but also unacceptable because I should have been able to get through this without ever taking damage. Okay, let's bring it back here a little bit. Let's slow it down here, SA. Unfortunately, you would think that secret room would allow us to like just go straight to the double lock door through it, but there's no through room there. So we have to go all the way around because I'm not walking back into the curse room. That's just a silly waste of HP. Life imitating art. But it's an in-the-room D20. So we have more bombs that we can use on tinted rocks.
Which will obviously get us some more soul hearts. We never get golden chest out of these.
Got one back here. We can go re-roll the store as well. Either for a half-price soul heart or maybe half-price premium. The item would be nice. Somebody asked, "What are premium items?" Premium items are the full cost items. These, the charge babies, the champion belts, the compasses, the treasure maps. Those are what I call premium items. There's no official designation in the game for them, but that's just what I call them. Like when like poker players, you're talking about you know, you're looking for premium hands, or if you're a slot machine player, you're looking for premium symbols. That's the type of logic that I'm using there. Okay, we really, really, really. Oh, one of those was a charge key, apparently. We really, really, really need damage, like real bad. If not damage, then movement speed. Ideally, what's the best update? What's the best upgrade here besides Magic Mush? Growth hormones. 100%. Got ourselves a lime horn. There you go. Eat yourself into your own bomb. Oh, that one didn't hit him. Thought for sure it would. Been having fun getting back into Elite Dangerous. Elite Dangerous is a game that I played since beta. I mean, Cat Nine Tails is great here. Oh boy. This is a... You talk about a rock and a hard place here. We can only take two of these. I have to take Guppy's Paw because it's a Guppy item. And we're going to need Guppy on this. So do we go for Contract from Below or do we go for Dark Prince's Crown? We can take Dark Prince's Crown, but it won't activate anytime soon. And also, it requires more than just itself to activate. Contract from Below, however, is universally good. So I'm going to go for Contract from Below. It is a little bit sketch because of our HP and our damage or our movement speed, but we should be okay. We just got to be a little careful here. Yeah, and being careful is not just doing... Just clicking buttons in the secret room. Are you seeing the arc on these shots? Gonna be in radio silence mode for a second here as we've got multiple NASA worms firing down upon us. Okay. So Cat of Nine Tails is gonna give us a shot speed up and a damage up as well. It's an excellent, excellent item. It used to be the butt of all jokes in Isaac. Now it's not so much. Not like that since Rebirth came out, really. Gotta be very careful here. Despite these being Globins, they still count as one full HP, and the computer stuttering all the time is not making it easy. You saw me in that fatty batty room there, that dead end that we went to. I know, surprise, surprise, but you can get out of dead ends by way of Dad's Key. Thank you, Gimpy. This is a real nasty room. I don't like it. Secret rooms, super secret rooms right there, and we do get the compass, but we cannot afford it yet. I'm not gonna use our only bomb for that because even if we get like best case scenario awesome withdrawal out of that, it's still not gonna be enough to pay for the compass. We're better off using that bomb for the keeper in the secret room. This room is also a huge trap. We're getting some very, very nasty rooms right now. I'm actually going to use a key. We have plenty of keys here. Yeah, this is exactly the reason why. So Dad's Key, I actually don't know if it will unlock the padlocks. I'm almost 100% sure it won't. But I've never thought about testing that before, so let's find out. This is just for experiment. I mean, there's still a lot of things in Isaac that I truly don't know. Just because, I mean, like, everything in Isaac is so situational that you never realize that you don't know something about something until you come across the situation that, you know, that I guess promotes having to think about it. Yeah, I didn't think so. Okay, so where do we go here? Definitely want the Book of Sin. Book of Sin plus contract from plus Gimpy should keep us alive long enough to sustain our HP. I'm going to unlock the Book of Secrets here just to maybe get us the map reveal. Hey, it did. And then our third book I will take is the Book of Shadows. So there's our bookworm. I'm not going to take the other two.
Victor, couldn't you have waited to see if you could have gotten a hangman card?
See, that's like that's what I'm talking about when we're talking about like situation. If that was a hangman card, I would have been pissed. That, like, situationally, like, you're not going to ever really come across the specific circumstance of needing, like, those exact items to answer a question, you know what I mean? Like, until you do. So it's impossible to really anticipate, you know, well, hey, I wonder if this does that. I wonder if this does that. You know, that sort of idea. So there's a and that kind of stuff for me happens all the time in Isaac just because I play so dang much. There's always these weird situations that I put myself in where I'm like, I actually don't know the answer to this question. I wish I did. And once I find out the answer, I try to retain that knowledge the best I can. I was going to check over here. It's going to be Gluttony, which we can't obviously reach, but, you know, what can he do? He does count as a champion, so I do not want to get hit by him. Funny game. Okay. So a little bit dicey here. We are going to say goodbye to Dad's Key. It's been lovely having you. But the Book of Sin gives us safety. It generates HP for us, it generates hearts, it generates money. I am still planning on using the... Oh, he spawned Champion Littlehorn. Boy, that's fun. So, yeah. So, all you who were looking at the boss, the most hated boss tier list, saying, like, Bighorn's not bad. What's better? This is the reason why he was put on We Can't Have Fun tier. Bighorn himself is not hard, but the fact that he spawns another boss... while he's still fighting, makes him ridiculous. Got an Ahuaz. Two bombs to get 10 cents. It's kind of a stretch, but I'm going to try. Yeah, that's supremely disappointing there. So we'll say goodbye to the compass, and we'll head on down. Darkness, hooray. Use AWAS just to see if we can get a crawl space. I feel like it's been forever since we've actually seen a crawl space. Contract from below still hooking us up fat, and I like that. Peter's still stuttering. I don't like that. Yeah, this is a super champion here, so if we got hit by that Globin, it would have cost two I mean, we're dead. Like, that's the end of the streak if we get touched by that thing. Alright, Book of Sin, I need you to... Here's the deal here, Tiger. I need you to step it up. We need these soul heart drops. I know you're a big-time player who can make big-time plays. You are beyond question in that field. But that being said, we need you to start making some big-time plays here. If the game is going to start spawning super champions on us, I am not prepared. I'm ill-prepared to handle the amount of damage that we're going to be intaking on just 1.5 soul hearts. A contract from below has really stepped it up here. So far, a contract from below and Cat of Nine Tails are the MVPs. I'm not doing that room. Caves 2, I think this is a boss... This is a boss item plus two soul hearts. Yeah. We finally do get movement speed here. A whole lot of it. We get a playing card. An Ace of Clubs. All right. Well, if we see another playing card, it's almost guaranteed it's going to be another Ace of Clubs. 1 cent away from Diplopia. Man. Let's find our item room. I hate that that white silkworm blocked for the dark silkworm. So yeah, so we're looking for just one penny. One penny gets us Diplopia, then Diplopia, I don't know if I want to get... I mean, getting Blanky, like, is real good. Especially in the situation where we find ourselves in very low HP land. But at the same time, Diplopia can also lead to a double Steam Sale if we find it in the store. So it's a matter of risk and reward here. I'll happily take that. Now, that one black soul heart definitely has me leaning more towards a little bit of the gambly side and say, okay, well, you know, now, especially since we can afford Diplopia in here, now I think it does benefit us greatly to try to get Team Mr. Beast here. We get another soul heart, plain and simple. Okay. So let's see if we can, this is a huge risk, mind you, but let's see if we can get Steam Sale to show up. It's not a huge risk. I mean, it's just, it's greedy. So it didn't happen. So now we have to decide on what are we going to do with Diplopia. Let's take it to our boss room. The correct play here is to go back and get the Book of Sin. So we're not wasting these full charges on our space bar item for nothing. Because obviously Diplopia doesn't have a charge. It's a one-time use only item that will double anything in the room, including item pedestals. We still don't know where our item room is either, which is also equally annoying. Yeah, so let's go back and let's go get... We can't be lazy about this, because again, we're still not in a... We're not in a good spot here. I didn't actually mean to buy that soul heart. I didn't even know that, honestly, that we even had that much money. Okay, here's our boss room. Still need our item room, though. They might be thinking, like, well, what's the... Well, who cares? Like, why would you even... pick up Diplopia right now, just wait till you get to like boss rush or something. Well, first off, we're not making boss rush. Secondly, we can use Diplopia in a devil deal to not cost us HP but still gain the benefits of the items that are there. And like if we got like double packed or something, that would be huge for us. I had barely enough damage there thanks to the bookworm shot to play chicken with that one. You're seeing me back away here. I know exactly how many shots these silkworms are going to take to eliminate them, given our current situation and our current damage. So you will eventually get to the point where you just unconsciously have this. You can just tell like what the HP is for these mobs, and that just comes with practice. I can't coach that. Like this one has two more shots, and it should be done. This one is done one more shot. And it may look like wow, those are like some Nostradamus genius calls. Like how does this guy know this? It literally is just from playing so much. You know exactly what the threshold is for certain enemies, given your damage and whatnot. You can just tell. That's the only way I can describe it, is that you can just tell. You know, over time, you'll do it unconsciously and without even thinking about it. I'm going to say no to Flatstone. I don't think that Flatstone is a wise pickup here. Namely because it's going to really hurt our shot speed and our range is going to kind of go downhill. I just wanted to prove a point. Hopefully you all believe me about that now. I wouldn't lie to y'all. There's stuff that I see in the game all the time that it just doesn't register in. But again, that little experiment, it's not even an experiment because it's guaranteed. But you can try it for yourself. It doesn't matter what the seed is. Just find a playing card in the store and get it. I forgot to go back and get Diplopia. I knew there was a reason why I was going back to the store other than to buy that playing card. Oh, these gurglings and these sliding around physics. I'm almost tempted just to black heart bomb the last two here, but I'm not going to. All right, it's a 73% chance. We know we're not going to get W anyway, so it doesn't matter that I forgot Diplopia. Doesn't even matter. See? Told you. Do we stick with the Book of Sin or not? I think you have to stick with the Book of Sin here. So, now the question becomes, what do we use Diplopia on if we're going to use it on this floor? Well, we can see what these two cards are. or if we want to risk it, we can go look for maybe some golden chests. It is possible that there could also be a challenge room. The challenge room is probably the most likely scenario here. I still haven't found the secret room either, so that could also be a possibility. Oh, just they spawn perfectly to where I can't access that. All right, well, here's our secret room. I have no interest in doing that room again. Okay, so there's a boss trap room here. Got completely swarmed by those spiders. That's the consequence of coming down from the middle of the room. Had we actually entered in through this door, that it literally is impossible for that to happen. But because we entered through the top here, that's what created that scenario. Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, but before I do that room, though, I am going to go back and get the Book of Sin.
Invicta, you should have bombed the Keeper in the secret room before you went to the boss, you nerd. Why didn't you do that?
Because 73% chance with the deal with the devil is the same as an 80% chance, or 77.5% chance to deal with the devil. We still ain't hitting it. I don't care who you think you've been watching over the last couple of minutes here, but you ain't watching somebody that's lucky. Now the blister brings up interesting things here. No, just open the chests, Isaac. Thank you. So I like the blister because the blister gives you a very nice amount of knockback. And I think it's better, honestly, than the walnut. But I want the walnut to pay out first, though, so I'm willing to fight Haunt without the blister, because we're probably going to take damage. I may even purposely take damage from him, just to see if we can get the walnut to crack, because that's HP right there. That's also HP right there. I will take the Eternal Heart, obviously. See if we can kamikaze this one hit. I don't mind sacrificing a couple of soul hearts here just to see if we can get the walnut to pay out. Okay, it's not paying out. Got a second Eternal Heart, that's fine. I'm gonna stick with the blister. The blister gives you a really nice pushback defense. And With the walnut not paying out, it would have only given us an HP upgrade anyway, so. Would have made the chocolate taste terrible. Wheel of 4chan. A cool card. When your damage is almost half of what your luck upgrade is, or luck stat is, you know you're in trouble. We're not in a good spot here, but I wouldn't say we're in trouble yet. All right. If you ask me the question, is this run good? The answer is a resounding no. This run is pretty trash through and through, except for Cat of Nine Tails, and us getting Roid Rage was perfect. Us getting a second speed upgrade after one upgrade is pretty trollish. using the orbit of that room's gravity just to kind of bend a shot around the corner there. All right. Well, we've seen almost every book on this run, except for the ones that, you know, give us guaranteed soul hearts. Only 4 bombs, make that 6. Worth doing here. So we can use this fool card to get out of the curse room to save us half of a soul heart. I think that's a good idea. I think it's a better idea to get out of a challenge room, if I'm honest. But let's find this item room first. This item room is pretty... This is a pretty important one. I'm actually stunned that gluttony mob is still alive. Or that this... Okay. Blister, you know I like you, but you're... With this amount of damage, you're not actually helping us right now. You're pushing stuff into us, and I can't have that. Apparently, we just do no damage. We haven't killed a single one of these mobs yet, I don't think. It's still alive. How is this possible? It's still alive, dude. Am I going crazy here? Am I going insane? How is this possible? We shot that gluttony mob at least 12 times. And without exaggeration. I am losing my freaking mind here. Are we doing no damage? I legitimately don't know if the game is bugged right now or not. This is absurd. We've got 4.5 damage, but what the heck is going on? It's like we're not dealing any damage to these mobs. Not a single one. You got to be kidding me. Dude, I've never seen anything like this in my entire life. How these mobs are still alive. Like, we've had bad damage before, but 4.57 damage is not zero damage. I mean, what is going on? I know it's a yellow champion. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is that previous mob here, but this one's also taking at least 30 shots now, something like that. If you count the double shot from the bookworm transformation, like we officially have not killed a mob in this room. The only reason why we killed one was because of the black heart bomb. We've been in this room for 3 minutes. Oh my god. Yes, get me the absolute heck out of here. Mom's knife, fine. Happy to have it. Good lord. I've never seen anything like that. I mean, it's not even the yellow champion that was just shrugging off those shots like we were doing nothing. It was the regular old mob. I mean, we hit it like 20 times. That was just insane. Thank goodness for the D4. Now, I'm not planning on sticking with mom's knife here, because I just want more movement speed. I'll take Headless Baby only because we're just going to be D4ing this stuff. Just get me out of this floor. Good God. And Curse the Blind. Well, When they ask you, how do you get a 31-minute mom kill in 2020? This is how. But obviously the D4 is going to alleviate a lot of our concerns. But I've never seen anything like that room, man. My point being in that last room was that we, 4.57 damage, it's not a lot of damage. It's not like we're doing gangbusters here. But at the same time, it's not like we've got no damage. It's not like we're sitting there with like 2 damage. We get Abba Dabba Ding Dong, movement speed, damage, tears. The beautiful thing. Now, what's unique to the D4 in this run specifically is the fact that we don't have a lot of items taken here. We're on Necropolis 2, and we've taken a grand total of 9 items. That's not a whole lot. 9 passive items, it is. And we'll take the left hand just because. I'm ready to shake off this craziness. That was alarming with how little damage we were doing in that room. And even then, like, the yellow champions aren't any... They're not that much tankier than regular champions. And it's not like it was a gold crown champion. Like, that would have taken... I mean, that was, like, the size of a mini-boss at that point. Got Magic Mush, Belly Button, Box, Binky, Dad's Coin, Meat, as well as DJs and Stem Cells. I'm going to be honest, I'm kind of tempted sticking with this one just because of Magic Mush. But at the same time, we're kind of like too far down the road now to really be satisfied with just taking like rerolls. I think that we just got to reroll for the entire run. Unless if I find something, like, really, really cool, you know. If we get Juice's Shadow, I'll definitely stop for a moment and turn into Black Juice, and then we'll just keep on going. But is this a one run now? Yeah, it's a one run. It's a one run now. It definitely was not until we got the D4. The D4 definitely bailed us out, and I am A-okay with that. I am 100% okay with that. Now we can actually have some fun. Nope. Because we have the D4, wow, back to back, and we got 9 lives too. Although we're about to reroll that. Got Spun. Actually, we didn't reroll 9 lives. Forgot you just keep it with you. There's growth hormones. What we need. We have Curse the Tower, a Torn Photo, Speedball. 2 very angry hollows here. You are the cause of your own downfall there, Hollow. Got the jar. Not really paying attention to that. Get some good deposits in here, and everything's honky-dory again in the world. Well, in the Isaac world. Temperance Machine, yeah. See if we have something like Cambion Conception or something like that. Of course, I also want to get down to Polar Invincibility. We got a lot of... We have a really, really good amount of damage here for this one as well. But I always want more. We can always go Zanier. Super Secret Room might be here. And it is. Yeah, sure. You know, this is... Hey, I was talking about yesterday. I wouldn't mind facing Mega Stanley. Mega Stan's been—he's been sitting high and dry lately. Old Hushy's been the one who's been our whipping boy, but not anymore. If we can fight Mega Stan, I'd be happy with this. Although if we are planning on fighting him, then I need to make sure that we've got enough firepower to do so. Crack Crown. There's Dark Mum. And it's really hard for me to give up a 4-tier delay. 4-tier delay and Dark Bomb. We have so many red hearts. We still have not found the no. We still have not found the item room yet. There we go. So because of Spun and divorce papers. Oh, we also have marbles as well. Actually, you know what? With marbles, If you D4, if you D4 an item, it does not remove marble, like something that you swallow. So what marbles can do is it can trigger the gulp effect, which means that you're going to swallow the trinket, and it assigns that to Isaac as a passive item. And when you D4 or D100 that, it doesn't count. I'm going to purposely... do we want to purposely drop a life here? I probably shouldn't, because it's going to ruin our double deal chance. And I just want marble. I just want marbles, I should say, to, okay. that's a whole lot of red hearts we just got. I want to gulp Krat Crown, and I want to gulp the goat's hoof. There we go. All right, so Krat Crown is now a permanent upgrade. Even if we reroll, we still have it. So I'm going to do the same thing over here for Goat Hoof, because our movement speed is just abysmal right now. And I can tell it's probably because we have Thunder Thighs and maybe Lard at the same time. Well, it's a movement speed upgrade, so I can't complain about that. I will continue to hold on to the left hand, though. We got the movement speed that I wanted. The only downside here now is the fact that we just have so many red hearts that it's almost a guarantee we're not going to get a double deal here. We're probably going to take red heart damage somewhere. We got Red Mom, of course. Red Mom drops down her foot a lot more often and a lot faster. Some people would say that Red Mom is probably the hardest. I would probably agree with that if you're not ready for it. We didn't actually take damage from her, which is a surprise. Get Sack Altar. Jade, hooray. Oh, what a fantastic trade-off that was. Sorry, Dark Bum. And another Curse of the Wind. Our DPS is looking solid here with a 4-tier delay. We're firing ping pong balls now. Our DPS is looking very, very healthy. Movement speed still a concern. Am I still going to D4? Of course I'm going to D4. This is just a D4 festival that I swear to you I'm not going to spoil in the thumbnail. Have Beelzebub. There's our flying. Oh my god. Oh, we also got conjoined. Oh boy. Do we want to? Oh, and we have my reflection too. What is this? We have a little hush. Yeah, BBF. No, thank you. I am. Well, hang on a second. We just got purity. Purity makes this a little bit more enticing. Wait. What happened to our 1-tier delay? I see purity. Like, I know we have it. We lost movement speed. Do we have Libra? No, we do have Goat Head, though. I'm almost tempted to hold on to Goat Head before re-rolling this floor. Or no, you know what? Is it Epiphora? No, we don't have Epiphora. Huh. It's hard for me to tell exactly what purity aura we've got. I mean, it looks like we have the blue one, but our tiers keep fluctuating, though, and it's a little bit strange. Well, I mean, we're going to re-roll this run. I want to wait until we get to the boss room to take advantage of the goat head that we got. That's $3 bill is also... What is this maddening sound? This is what happens when you have 8 luck and tough love, by the way. Oh, and fire mine. Okay. All right. $3 bill, you wore out your welcome. We got Tech 2 Tiny Planet. Still a decent amount of damage despite having Tech 2, but I do not want to walk through this world with Tech 2. Got Guppy's head. Gonna give us Guppy, of course. We still have Tough Love. We also got Umfriend, SMB Superfan. Nothing too spectacular so far. Other than the pure, oh, we have scatter bombs as well. Yeah, let's get out of here. Ain't nobody got time for them scatter bombs. You can take your scatter bombs and get out. Oh yeah, it's the matriarch too. What a fun boss. Deal with the devil, no surprise there. We get Stigmata, which is an excellent item. Unfortunately, I did roll through my goat head, so we did not get the guaranteed devil deal there. Not that it really matters, of course. At the end of the day, it's a D4 run. Did Raku. So, as I was talking about earlier before we ran into that super champion, I've been having a lot of fun playing Elite Dangerous, getting back into the game. Oh, we have Epic Fetus. And you know, I'm grinding out rep right now. I'm trying to get a new awesome, sweet looking spaceship to play around in, and it's got me rejuvenated to wanting to play Eve again. And I know that a couple months ago I was talking about wanting to get back into Eve. Like, I always want to get back into Eve, because Eve is consistently one of my favorite games ever. But somebody contacted me back then, and it was a gentleman who I don't remember the name of, and I apologize, because if you ask me to remember something past, like, a month, I'm not going to remember it. But they had contacted me about joining their corporation. So if you happen to be that person, please send me an email again. Sinvicta316@gmail.com. I would definitely love to get back into Eve and play with a corporation that that would kind of teach me the ways of not only PvP, because I've never actually PvP'd in Eve, but also I still want to do PvE stuff. I know that Eve also has a Eve Online, by the way, that's what I'm talking about. Eve Online has a new expansion coming out very soon. We got Eden's Blessing. Oh, we have Marked, yeah. Let's go ahead and just nope on out of there. Ooh, this is interesting. Now we got the apple, which apparently the Azer raids do 4x damage, not double. So sorry about misspeaking on that. But we have Tech Zero, the Mulligan, apple, rubber cement. Now rubber cement and Tech Zero are what makes this kind of interesting. The left hand has been going ham for us. I guess I can get rid of the left hand now since we don't technically need it. Oh, we also have Kidney Stone. Yeah, Kidney Stone kind of ruins it for me, not gonna lie. If you happen to play Eve Online and you were the gentleman who contacted me last year when I was talking about it, please send me another email. Or if you just happen to be an Eve player and you're looking to get someone who wants to learn how to PvP and stuff, and who is still kind of a noob but I can learn, shoot me an email. Oh boy. That reroll could not come fast enough here. Isaac's heart and soy milk and Cricket's body and sad bombs. Little Gertie, the relic. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna... Oh, we also have Lusty Blood, apparently. But we're gonna need that reroll toot sweet here. It's French. Look it up, sweetheart.
Drop the left hand, Sinvicta. You're going to forget about it when you go to the chest.
would never do such a thing. To suggest that I, the professional Binding of Isaac player Sinvicta, would forget to drop the left hand before going into the chest. Find it greatly offensive, sir or ma'am. And we have reached the epitome. We have officially peaked. Tech X, the mind, and Strange Attractor. You know you're on the final legs of a reroll run when you finally get Tech X. Now, Tech X and not Hamilacria, but Lacrimagery don't do anything together. Oh, apparently the D4 rolled. Did that roll away our black rune? I was kind of hoping we would have that, but I guess it's actually better that we don't have the black rune, because that just leaves us less items to roll through. Most likely, Tech X is going to be our tier effect to end the run, but we'll see. See what we get out of the chest here. Sissy, how you doing, Sissy? Little Sissy, there she is, there she is. Little Sissy, we can't re-roll you, Sissy. Never. I would never re-roll Little Sissy. She's just happy she could make an appearance today. She's happy that she can kick off a brand new week for y'all. Hope it was a good one. Thank you, everyone, for supporting the Animal Crossing series. Don't miss today's episode, which I haven't actually recorded yet, but I'm planning on showing you all. Some more interesting stuff out of there. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, Sissy loves you. And thank you all very much. Welcome all new subscribers here. Passing 141,000 subs now is unbelievable. Hope you all had a great start to your brand new week here. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.